So Raji and Brett, in your contributions, you touched on the dual use mechanisms. Raji, I think you come down on the favour of the so-called TCMs, the transparency and confidence building measures, which has nothing to do with intercontinental missile. In the dual use area, what do you see as one of the first early opportunities for a confidence building measure? Generally, everyone talks, as you did, both you and Britt and Linda spoke about debris, tracking, notice. These things are straightforward, but in the dual use area, and we will not get away from a defence aspect of space. As Andrew said in his contribution, defence planners will want at least situational awareness. So what are some of the early beginners on confidence building measures in the dual use area?
I think one of the first thing is not to interfere with other countries. That can be a pledge, that can be a kind of important confidence building measures that can be taken up. The second one, and somewhat related, would be to kind of not first placement of weapons. Again, I understand the difficulties associated because no clarity on what a weapon is. And for instance, as we talked about the space debris cleaning technology, anything that goes up can be. And for instance, if you are able to maneuver a satellite, if you're able to clean up a particular, remove the debris piece, you can use the same technology, same means to do, engage in some other nefarious activities. So I think there are problems associated with some of the TCBMs that I'm talking about, but I think it's also kind of builds into a certain amount of confidence with each other. I think so, no first placement, one TCBM, but I think non-interference of each other's peaceful activities, I think that can be another important aspect. I think that pledge has to be kept up. But in the current times, I think there is going to be a lot more, countries are going to be suspicious. And I think this also relates to the broader geopolitical shift and balance of power. And therefore, until such time that you have somewhat a more stabilization of balance of power equations among states, I think this is always going to be difficult. Countries are always going to be wary of each other, wary of each other's capabilities, what one might do despite the rhetoric, despite the statements and kind of things. So unfortunately, you're going to see a difficult phase in the coming years, for a few years, actually.
Brett?
First, I'm going to agree entirely with what Raji said. We saw great effort, including from Australia, to become part of the code of conduct discussions, which collapsed in 2013 from memory. Essentially, China and Russia said, no, we don't want to play with this anymore, having worked really carefully with the United States for 5 or 6 years, and then they pulled back. And I think that's a matter of deep regret. Of course, we have in the United Nations the first committee in Geneva, absolutely deadlocked on space security, versus the fourth committee, which looks after the peaceful uses of outer space committee, trying to do things. An interesting point on that, and then I'll finish. The first chair of the technical committee of Committee on the Peaceful Uses of Outer Space was an Australian, and indeed an Australian chaired that committee for the first 30 years of its life, two Australians, one after the other. We've done this before. The space agency coming into being means that we now have mirroring in the international relations domain, which I think is really great. And I think that we can now start to make the sorts of contribution that this country has been a bit reluctant to make publicly for a long time, and we can come back into play. And that's a great gift to the world.
Linda, you've previously chaired one of the Parliament's very important security and intelligence committees. Any thoughts on the dual use issue?
I do. I don't see the dual use in terms of threats or opportunities any different in the space domain as in any other technological area. And I think one of the great examples of that we've got right here in West Australia is, said before, the Desert Fireball Network. Extraordinary collaboration with NASA. And now with Lockheed Martin. So you've got a civilian application, a research application that Lockheed Martin have picked up as Fire Opal, and that's now being trialled globally. So you've got a great military civilian capability here. So I think I see it's no different in space as in any other opportunities.
All right, well, I have achieved my part of the bargain, which was to have this panel conclude by 3:10. My instruction now is you have no more than 10 minutes for afternoon tea. You are to be back here by 3:20. Let's please thank our panel. Thank you.